Hey everyone, okay, we're going to resume Maize. This is part three. Resume our game. So we left off where we created Vladdy Ruxpin, and he was going to join us. We're going further down into the bunker, underground facility, whatever you want to call it. Get my controller going here. Uh-oh. Why did it save?
Bloody stay here while you do your stupid things.
No! What? Did I not save in the right spot?
Ah, idiot. So you are done being stupid up there. Good. Where we go?
Am I still crouched? Yes. Okay, so let's go back to... Did this spot not open up for me? Did it not save in the right area? What's going on here? Yeah, okay, this is open. Alright, so... Down we go. That scared me for a minute there. I thought we lost our... save game, but apparently not. Down we go. What is this? What do I do? A broken security checkpoint. Why does it have Vladdy's face on it? Vladdy! Oh. Vladdy, where you at? I hear you squeaking. Where you at, my man? Here he comes. So
what? Why is that Vladdy's job? What is Vladdy supposed to do?
Come on, Vladdy, just do this for me this one time. I give you this English muffin.
This stupid thing will never work. It is, huh? Okay.
What? Facial recognition security checkpoint. Oh. Okay, an item can be placed here. So this is the coat rack, and then what else do I have? This jumpsuit, and the headband, and the, what? It's the Sketcher, no? What do I do, Vladdy? Something else, it looks like. All right, let me read about my item. So I'm missing something that goes with this? This is definitely the Sketcher, no? Okay, Vladdy, we gotta go look for something else, I guess. Initiate security check. We're missing an item, Vladdy. I don't know what I need here. Well, it's not this. I thought we had explored everything. I don't know what else it could be. It's something that's kind of the shape of this. Okay, so it needs a face on it, right? For facial recognition. So do we need something with either Bob's face or Ted's face on it? right? You got any ideas, Lottie? If it's facial recognition, we need something with their face on it. So let's go back to the lobby. No. Can I sketch his...
There are too many containers in here. Lottie does not like it.
Can I sketch his face? Ah, okay. Use portrait as inspiration for the worst facial sketch in the world. All right. Sorry, Vladdy. Come on, buddy. I think I got it figured. Why did it make me crouch? Did I have to crouch in that spot? Vladdy, come on. Hey, buddy. All right. This way? No, that is not it. Sorry, Vladdy, I got lost. What was that? That was just his note, right? Yeah, okay. Sorry, Vladdy, I got lost. Here we go. So now, will this go on? I hope. Yes. Is that actually gonna work for Bob's face? All right. Facial recognition security checkpoint.
You must be joking. That never worked. Well, that was still stupid.
Don't be such a pessimist, Vladdy. Come on. All right, here we go. Level 00. What is this? West hook control. Come on, Vladdy. You coming? Come on, buddy. Vladdy Ruxpin. Hey, look, you opened a door. Yeah. Whoa, new music. All right, so let's start here. I feel like I'm crouched, but I'm not. Right? No, I'm not. Ooh, this goes up. All right, let's check this out first. This isn't a bad idea. Sub 01. Okay. What is this? Oh, sub, like submarine? They park a sub in here? Here's some notes. Hiya, Ted. Since this is a highly sensitive area, I added a new security door. No need to thank me. Can't be too careful. Bob. Bob, you do realize that your new security door closes for no reason and locks people inside this very secure area? Stop being cheap and get a door that works, moron. Cordially, Ted. I have a feeling I'm going to get locked in here, right? Here's... something. An item can be placed here. Well, here's a key. Hiya, Ted. Just FYI, I brought the acetylene gas tank up to the farm for the annual staff barbecue. Completely corn-free, of course. Haha, Bob. Bob, how many times have I told you that we can't have barbecues on the farm? Put it back. We're days behind schedule. And stop joyriding with the tractor, dummy. Cordially, Ted. Alright, I have a feeling I'm going to get locked in here because it says the door closes for no reason or something. There's a pallet. What do I do with the pallet? Oh, I just picked up a skid. Small key. It's a shame you don't have small hands, as handling this key would be much easier. It looks like a key for a toolbox lock, which could be useful if you can find the fine motor skills needed to operate such a small instrument. Am I going to have to get Vladdy to use the key? You decided to pick this loading skid up because you liked the direction of the grain in the wood and that it gave you splinters while holding it from every conceivable angle. Alright, what's this? Oh no.
Stupid American garbage.
Yeah, let's see. Can I not pick this up? There. An instruction manual for building your very own two-man submarine. Since Bob and Ted opted for the budget model, the manual is 800 pages long and mapped out in a fashion that is similar to a choose-your-own-adventure novel. Build your new submarine in 1,357 easy-to-read steps. Lockheed DF-48 discount two-man submarine assembly instructions. Okay. Use the small key to unlock the toolbox. And what did I just get? A hammer and a box cutter. Box cutter, the cheapest box cutter commercially available. This brand holds the distinction of being the only one that is rendered completely useless after one swipe. Yeah, okay. And the hammer. For some reason, you feel the urge to break something beautiful with this instead of doing the standard task of hammering a nail. You don't know why you think these things. Okay, so here's some boxes. Are there any that aren't open that we can use the box cutter on? Nothing in the box. Here's a box. Oh, open. Okay. Here's a bunch of steel boxes. Latex gloves. Can we go in there? No. Oh, here's something. What is this? Water pipe. This magic water pipe grants you the power to transport water from one end of it to the other. There will be no reason for you to do this at any point in this adventure, but you will continue to carry it anyway, just in case. That's nice. I like how it takes shots at like other games. I might need this. Okay. What is? Oh yeah. Those were the notes I read already. What's this? An approved design for a loading crane. Created by Pete's Games and Carnival, the design of the loading crane appears to be based off a simple claw game, a fact which excited Bob to no end. Ted, conversely, wasn't too thrilled about it, but was stuck with it anyway after Bob forged his signature on the approval form. Approved! Why? Oh, you scared me there, Vladdy. That was weird. You came crawling into the top of my screen. So they plucked the submarine with the crane. Crane game, crane. Pluck the submarine out of the water. There's the crane.
Hey, water. Blood is favorite.
Do I go in here? No. Okay, here's some... Hey, Ted, I upgraded the lifting system so two people could use it at once. Our efficiency will nearly double. Oh, no. Bob, know that I do not say this lightly, but this may well be the absolute worst idea you've ever had, idiot. Cordially, Ted. So, do I need to get Vladdy to work the other side of this thing? Alright, let's figure out what's going on here first. What is the... Oh, what's this? Bob, for the last time, stop leaving your junk everywhere! I don't... know why you even have a cello case. You don't even own a cello, dummy. Cordially, Ted. Alright, so what's in the cello case? A locked cello case. Do I have anything? Can I smash it? Locked cello case. So I need another key? Oh, here's a box. Hey, Ted, need this box of knickknacks loaded. Be a pal and move it for me, would you, Bob? Bob, you sloth, I'm not your errand boy. Load it yourself. Cordially, Ted. Okay, so let's cut the box. Pine cones? Open strange box. Oh, it's filled with Fabergé eggs.
Why you pick up so much garbage, idiot? Vladdy does not understand.
You should like this, Vladdy. Fabergé eggs are Russian. Bob got his hands on these extravagant artifacts because he knew a guy and bought them in bulk so he could get a slight discount. He kept them even after he learned that they didn't contain any chocolate. Fabergé eggs. Alright, so there's an egg-shaped thing over here. So if I put... what's back here? Anything? If I put this on the table and smash it with a hammer, because it said I'm supposed to... I have a need to break something fragile with this. So let's smash it. And what is this? You smash the priceless Fabergé egg with a hammer for some reason. What did I pick up? Priceless lockpick? Easily the most expensive lockpick in the world, but you don't really care because you have no idea how modern economics work. Alright, so I'm going to take the lockpick and open up the cello case, right? This game is pretty straightforward. Whoa. You use the most expensive lockpick in history to unlock the cello case. Vladdy won't say this, but he probably could crawl through that vent and unlock the door. Alright, what did I pick up? Nuclear fuel rod. For reasons known only to you, you are holding a very radioactive fuel rod in your hands, ignoring every known safety procedure for proper containment and storage imaginable. Okay, Vladdy. So apparently you can go through this vent over here. Yeah, look at this. Oh, and so it lights up with his face when it's something for him.
In there? Oh, what's the boy?
How else are we gonna get out, Vladdy?
Stupid idiot, making Vladdy crawl through dumb thing. What is Vladdy supposed to do in here? Stupid! Stupid wires everywhere! Why is this stupid? Why is this stupid thing upside down? Makes no sense! How stupid are these idiots? Maybe if Vladdy gets... Vladdy has to... Oh! I can't do this stuff! Boy, grai so mignon!
You did it, Vladdy!
Hey, idiot!
Yeah?
Did that work?
Yeah, it worked.
Stop being stupid and say something.
It worked. It worked, Vladdy.
Vladdy done anyway. Dwi moi lushi drugs, stupid idiot. Could get nowhere without Vladdy. Vladdy has to do everything.
Thanks, Vladdy.
So, now what?
I don't know. I got this nuclear rod. Vladdy did not like any part of that experience. Also, a new path is open to you, probably somewhere radioactive. Okay. So, alright, we'll go back down. I feel like a new path opened already. I feel like I hardly explored any of this. I just took the first turn. Alright, so... let's try this way. I wish I knew what was the new path, because I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. Wish I had seen what was blocked off. What? Is this another lobby? What? Bob, you buffoon! Why is there a lobby here? And what happened to the decontamination room? Hiya, Ted. Pretty sure I told you. Did a little rework here. Think this will be a real high traffic spot for the tour. Gonna be a real moneymaker, Bob. He still think there's a tour. Words fail me, idiot. Cordially, Ted. Oh, he actually spelled cordially wrong that time. Cordially. And stop it with the statues, cordially Ted. This one looks different. Oh, here's another note. What is this? flyer for a local pool. Flyer for Paul's Pools and Pest Removal advertises big savings for orders within a 20-mile radius of the shop, along with a free extermination of one pest. The cheapest pool in the flyer has been circled several times in red. Bob, I noticed this flyer and assumed this was your work, so I will remind you, pools are not safe to hold chemical waste. Why did you order one? Stupid! Cordially, Ted. And like, look, Bob's got his picture on both sides now. Okay, so what's in here? There's something there. Oh, there's something here. What is this? Coffee maker. You took this not because you want to make coffee, but that you heard that coffee machines grant you one wish. After much thought, you wished for coffee, and it didn't come true. They sure keep it lively. Like, it's definitely worth reading all of the items. Lobbies, lobbies, lobbies for you. A brochure for a company whose main goal is to fulfill all your low to mid-level lobby needs. On the back, one design in particular is circled in red pen, the cheapest one. The company tagline reads, "Waiting never felt so good." Waiting in the lobby never felt so good. Okay, so what is this?
Try not to be an idiot in there. It would be very bad. Let me stay here in case you do something stupid.
Am I supposed to take the nuclear rod in there? What is this? All right, let me read some of these notes. What does this say? Reserve power mode active. What is that? Restart the nuclear reactor? Do I need the nuclear fuel rod for that first? This is quite possibly the worst written book of guidelines in the history of time. None of the guidelines make sense, and the instructional drawings all consist of a stick person running away from a large fire. Nuclear meltdown prevention. Peace edition, does that say? Alright, let me read the... What is this? Let me read these notes. Bob, I have made this map so our staff can restart the bargain basement reactor you ordered without blowing us all to kingdom come. Do me a favor and don't come anywhere near it, moron. Cordially, Ted. Ted, I solved your maze. It took me a little while, but I got it in the end. Bob, oh my god, he wrote all over it. Am I gonna have to do this? Bob, how are you this stupid? Did you get your doctorate out of a cereal box? Cordially, Ted. Okay, what does that say? Containment control, core access. So... am I gonna have to do this? All right, let me, okay, do I go in there first with the reactor rod? Let me see. So, if I'm going in there, well, I'm gonna get turned around when I get down the stairs. It looks like I pretty much go around the outside wall. I don't know. All right, we'll figure it out as we go. Come on, Vladdy. You're not coming with me? I don't think Vladdy's coming. Whee! What's this? Okay. What do I do? Open the door to the reactor room. Can I die in here? Bob P. McTavish commemorative reactor. Okay, what is this? Containment control. Initiated installation procedure and started a countdown to a nuclear explosion. Move quickly. Oh my god, there's a timer. Okay. So I think I just go kind of around the edge. Oh no. This is bad. Am I possibly going the right way? That looks like a dead end. What happened? Dead end. Oh no, I'm doing terribly. I have no idea if I'm even going the right way now. What is this? What is this? Fuel rod containment canister. Place fuel rod in containment canister. Now run back and hit that button again before you blow up. Oh crap. No. This is where I got lost before. What do? I'm gonna blow up. I don't know. I'm back at the start. I don't want to do this again. What is the other way to go? Run! There's no way I'm gonna make this. Boom! Well, you really blew it. You should probably try that again. Birdie blew it! Okay. Hopefully I can do it this time. No! Let's go! This way? Not this way. What? Oh, please tell me I didn't go back the way I came. Went back the way I came. I'm gonna blow up again. Horribly, oh my god, I had 3 seconds left. Horribly unsafe fuel rod. I almost wanted to look at the clock just to see how much time I had before I hit the button. Thank god I didn't, I would have blown up. Okay, so now, hey Vladdy, I did it. What do you think? What do you think, bro? What do I do? That's it in here, right? Okay, so now we go up here and click restart reactor button. What's going on in here? It's weird. Don't criticize me, Vladdy. And now I restarted the worst nuclear reactor in the world. So, oh, what does this say now? Facility power status. Okay. Alright, sweet. What's over here? That's just where we walk through. Okay, we done in here then, Vladdy? Come on, Vladdy. I hear your little squeaky feet. You're coming with me. Okay, so what did that say? Probably to somewhere very radioactive. So that was the thing that opened up to me, right? Can we go this way? Is there anything up here?
It's too dark in here. I can't see a thing. Perhaps if we turned around.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. This is a perfectly nice place to stand.
Well, I can't argue with that logic. Neither can I.
Hey, guys. What is this? Door to room number 4. Vladdy, are you stuck? Do you need lift up, buddy? Are you stuck, Vladdy?
What is this stupid thing?
What is this thing? Oh, there's another thing here for him. But I should probably look around first. Oh, the rings. She said... What did the Ruby Princess say to do? Make the sun shine again and raise the rings, right? What is this? Control console slot. So I need a control console. What is this? An existentially unstable rock. This rock has no idea whether it is a rock, a facsimile of a rock, an amalgamation of many rocks, or a non-rock. By picking it up, you have undone all of its conclusions about the world up until this point. You have named it Wallace. Okay. So we have 3 rocks now, our growing rock collection. Okay, so I'm assuming that whatever I need for here is in a different area. So let's, do I send him in here?
Again with the crawling?
I don't know.
Stanya Veselo. Oh, what is Vlade doing here? Is this Vlade's purpose? Crawling and climbing? Through stupid junk to get more stupid junk? And for what? This stupid garbage?
Is it
this
the control console?
No use, no purpose, just more garbage. Garbage for idiots. Always.
Vladdy Ruxpin, are you okay?
Garbage.
What is it? Yeah, that's what we need.
Worth Vladdy suffering, but already know the answer. No,
yeah,
because
I need
it's garbage.
It. No, I need that.
What stupid thing is next?
Thank you, Vladdy. That's exactly what I needed. Vladdy is really starting to hate Vince. I need this. Hook control console. Okay. Is that the hook? Let's see. What do I do?
So, this is what stupid thing does? Vladdy still think it garbage.
That thing you did was important, probably. All right, Vladdy, we did a good thing, buddy. I don't think there's anything else in here. Oh, what is this? Why
Bloody think you may have problem, idiot. You take too much garbage.
You take too much garbage. Door wheel broke off its door thanks to a shoddy soldering job done immediately after the facility Christmas party. You could probably find another door to fit it onto. Just not this one. Okay, so we need that to open another door somewhere else. Hey, the corn guys are gone. Alright, so that's the... probably the other end has a door with no handle on it, I'm assuming. Still with me, Vladdy? And then we're gonna probably go down here. That'll be the next area that opens up to us. Still with me, Vladdy? Come on, little Vladdy. Come on, Vladdy Ruxpin. Up you go. Yeah, see, this has no handle. Okay, and what does this say? West hook number 2. An item can be placed here. Okay, so this is gonna be another one of these. Oh. Oh. This looks like a teleporter, like from The Fly. Can I read the note? Nope. Let's go through here. Looks like Jeff Goldblum's The Fly. Teleportation. What is this thing? An item can be placed here. Well, I need a stool, obviously. That's a stool shape. Alright, let's go. Blew, shiver. Blew. Let's push this button. Okay. So that one's good to go.
That does not sound good.
Uh-oh. Broken.
Chitanya Vesilo. Why is this place so stupid? Nothing works. Idiot American machines.
What was that?
Well done, idiot. Breaking it will help, stupid. So take that dumb piece, see if you can fix it.
Okay. Breaking everything won't help you progress, in case that wasn't clear. Well, I didn't know. All right, give me this piece. A new path is open to you. Head back to the communal grotto and down to level 2. Okay, so I need to fix that piece, obviously. The communal grotto? What? Now this area is blocked off. So I guess we're going here. Wait, what? Head back to the communal grotto and down to level 2? I don't even know where I would go. The what? Communal grotto, okay.
Useless garbage everywhere.
Down to level 2? Was this blocked before? Oh, this is up.
So boy, what a mess. Is this place where all the garbage come from?
Yeah, pretty much. All the garbage has come from here. Okay, in the communal grotto and down to level 2. Oh. Okay, to level 2. Okay, Vladdy, I got it. I got it figured out. Alright. Ooh. Vladdy, you with me, bro? Okay.
time Vladdy told you where he is from. Vladdy is from small box, very dark, then stupid idiot brought him out the box, and it was sad. Now, we are here.
Aw, Vladdy, you need a hug, buddy. Do need a hug. We got another lobby here. Alright, what does this say? Love you, stupid dummy. Why you commissioned that artist to make these maps is beyond me. They are unreadable. Everyone is getting lost down here. Cordially, Ted. This is a map? You are here. Okay, here's the thing. What is this? Broken gear half. You need to figure out a way to repair this broken gear if you want to raise the giant hook to the sky. The fact that you know nothing about engineering, mechanical repairs, or finding things means this will probably go very smoothly. Yeah. Night Danger 2. Danger. A Mick Murphy mystery. After an unexpected hit, the maligned author was forced to write a sequel. This time, he saved everyone the trouble of reading the book altogether and revealed the killer on the back flap. The novel actually chronicles the detective's struggle to return a pair of defective pants. Another completely lazy mystery novel. Okay. What does this say? Bob, I don't care how good a deal you got. No more lobbies, idiot. Cordially, Ted. All right, here we go. What? Oh, this is one of the rooms I saw. Are we gonna run into that guy? There's a lot of stuff here. This is one of the rooms I saw when I followed the yellow path, I believe. The meeting room. All right, let's go in here. Apparently I need a water cooler. You were mistakenly trying to pick up something else, but now you are in possession of an entire water cooler. You're too stubborn to put it down, so you're going to find a use for it, carrying it everywhere you go. You didn't even empty out the water. Oh my gosh. All right, what else? So what did he actually put on here? A stupid. Do I look like a scarecrow? Is that me? A lot of wine. Oh, here's something. What is this? It's quite a few things. A red marker. Outline for the facility, theme park, and casino. My God, Bob, what is this? There's no way in any conceivable universe that we can turn this facility into a resort. Stop it, you dummy. Cordially, Ted. All right. So what do have I got here? Red marker. You mistakenly thought this was a blue marker, but you don't want to put it down lest you hurt its feelings. Instead, you will draw a face on something with it because you know it likes to do that. Okay, welcome to Redacted Land. Theme park and casino construction outline. A very slick looking proposal to rework the facility into a high-end theme park and casino resort. Has lots of pleasing looking graphs pointing upwards, so you know for sure that it's a good idea. Some notable attractions include Vatland, Genetics Kingdom, and Kitchen. Yeah, I've never seen a projection that I didn't like, right? Okay. I think that's it for here. So we got the red marker. We use it on the board or anything? No. Okay, and then what was... Oh, here's a computer. Oh, here's something. What is this? An item can be placed here. All right, well, that's my water cooler. And then... I need a plant, it looks like, and maybe a beach ball or something. Oh, and here's something else I need too. What? Oh, I hear those guys. Okay, let me look at this computer first. Facility recognition. Okay, so this is another one. Yeah. Hiya, Ted. Since you're so worried about security, I did you a favor and beefed up the doors to your room. You're absolutely welcome, Bob. Bob, you jerk, I can't even get into my room because of these stupid discount security measures. Fix it. I'm sick of sleeping in the grotto. Cordially, Ted. Okay, so if this is Ted's room, now we have to find a way to make it look like Ted. Right? Oh, there's another rock. Workplace readiness. Giving up on the Corn's ability to be weaponized on any level, the scientists attempted to see if they could be of any use in the general workplace. They weren't, opted to take naps instead. However, the Corn did display a fondness for stacking orange boxes, which they did so every chance they could, the goal of which seeming to be directing the researchers to do what they wanted. That's hilarious. Oh, look at all those notes down there. How do I get there? A rocky rock. Now, this is a rock that knows its place in the world, unquestioning, unwavering, happy, and basking in its complete and utter rockiness. You have named it Shelby. What are these guys doing? Oh, okay, this is one of the things I need. Sturdy box. And this is Ted, right? Oh my god, there's a giant statue of Bob. He made Ted so much smaller than him. That's hilarious. So, Bob, what do you think of this? See what you have driven me to? Jerk, cordially, Ted. Oh, so Ted made his own statue because he got sick and tired of all of Bob's statues. Hiya, Ted. This is great. Really excited to see you get into the spirit of things. Added one of mine so we could be side by side. Really think it balances the space well, Bob. Yeah, except yours is like 10 times the size to dwarf him. Oh my gosh, Bob. Your ego knows no bounds. All right, let me put the box here. Did Flatty just fall? Did he just fall? What the hell? Where did he go? Did he fall? Box. So I need a plant. What's over here? Oh my god, Bob. Cafeteria. I think I lost Vladdy. Oh, here's the plant I need.
You take so many useless things, idiot.
Where are you even? Bob, where's that idiot Fernando hiding? I know where Fernando is. I told him to refill the coffee trolley with Ranka, is that like Sanka? Weeks ago, if you find him, put him to work and do some yourself, buffoon, cordially, Ted. Can you hear the drums, Fernando? Okay, so this is the plant I need. Here's a door. Locked kitchen door, can be opened from the kitchen. Is there a vent I can send Vladdy into to go there? Vladdy, I need you to go through a crawl space for me again. Can be opened from the kitchen. How do I get him over there? Okay, let's go. And put the plant here. What? That's totally the plant, no? Alright, so, where was down? There's down over here. Let's just explore this floor first. Okay, this is all blocked off. I don't know where you went, Vladdy, but you went missing for a little bit. I'm pretty sure you fell off the map. Oh. Okay. So I have to make this. What is this? Need to have a poop, Vladdy? Capuchin treats. Bob mistakenly thought that capuchin was another word for delicacy and ordered thousands of boxes to snack on. When he was told that they were that the snacks were in fact for monkeys, he ate them anyway. Not surprised. Okay. Operation Suboquinium Evader. It's a small navigational chart on the Pacific Ocean with the very peculiar course plotted from the United States to an island in the middle of the ocean. The course has more in common with the movement of a small fly than in any nautical vessel. It's apparently part of Operation Suboquinium Evader. But owing to your poor understanding of languages, you mistakenly think that it's a chain restaurant specializing in Italian cuisine. Well, I butchered the name of it too. Oh my gosh, this is the path. We're like gonna go from California to Tokyo and Japan and down through all of these islands and oh my god. Fine. Bob. He does have good taste in video games though. He's got a Batari, which looks like an Atari with a Nintendo cartridge stuck in it. Alright, so pruning shears. I'm assuming I need to chop the top off of that plant. And then I need to figure out what the ball is. So do I do this? Trim plastic plant. It's much nicer now. Okay, so now I need... Oh, and I'm probably going to draw a face on the ball, if I can find the ball. Bought in bulk and commissioned in a variety of materials, Bob seems to have ordered more statues than can possibly be fit inside the facility. Due to this, a statue storage fee is also included. He did indeed get a discount, but the cost is so outlandish in the first place that the missing zero is barely noticeable. Statues from Mars. Alright, so where am I going to get the ball shape thing from? What do I do? Ooh, there's a litter box in the corner. Oh, here's something. What is this thing? Bob's journal. Written entirely in red pen, it isn't so much a journal as it is a mindscape with occasional pictures. Massive, ambitious plans are written down and abandoned midway through inception and sometimes mid-sentence. Bob. You see anything circular shape we can use? I was assuming it was going to be one of these lamps, but... Marching on. Ooh, nice chandelier. Okay, Vladdy, we're gonna try something else. We'll go down. Ooh, stuttery. Can I put this item up here or not yet? I can. Alright, I just need to place sheared plant in front of the camera. So I'm assuming it's gonna be down here then. What is this called? Assistance office. Is this Fernando's office? Ah, here's something circular. What is that? Medicine ball. What is this? Coffee trolley out of coffee. No, I can't do anything with that yet. What is this? Daily planner. The final page consists of 6 appointments. 9 a.m. do nothing. 11 a.m. pick up new fedora and glove. Oh, so this is Fernando's planner. 1988. Oh, that's the year for this game. 1988. Noon, torture stupid corn for amusement. Fernando, you're mean. 3 p.m., high to avoid work. 5:45, torture the corn. And 6 p.m., initiate master plan. Well, Fernando, how did that work out for you there, buddy? What is this? The master plan. What is this? Appears to be the only thing Fernando, the founder's assistant, put any effort into, aside from shredding important documents and wearing fancy fedoras and gloves. It's a very poor plan involving jumper cables, a strange lightning rod, and somehow turning into an all-powerful god. Notes read that the stupid corn told me their secret, and Bob and Ted will be my assistants now. Okay, so there's the lightning rod. It gets zapped with lightning. He's hooked to it with jumper cables, and then he turns into a giant man with big muscles. But it didn't work. He got fried. All right, there's a lot of notes here. Let's see. The 1 Second Assistant, a peculiar book on how to be an assistant in the workplace whose end appears to be do as little work as possible. Chapters include how to shred everything, an intro into hiding in the office, and shifting blame to the intern. That's hilarious. All right, what do all these notes say? Hiya, Fernando. Could you be a pal and place the tour brochures across the facility? There's only a few hundred, so you'll be able to do that in no time flat. Fernando, you cretin. Ignore that idiot Bob's request. What you really need to do is sort the samples in the genetics lab from the least reactive to the most. So go do it. Cordially, Ted. Heya, Fernando. Got a more important job for you than that. Need the statue directly above you moved about an inch or so. The scaffolding's already set up, so you'll finish it in about an hour or so. Thanks. Fernando, you lazy oaf, don't touch that statue. We don't need another insurance claim. Instead, go to the second floor of the barn and observe the corn's behavior in their habitat for several days. Cordially, Ted. And don't move a muscle. That'll throw the data off. Cordially, Ted. Hey, Fernando, don't worry about that observation stuff. The corn will take their own notes. Really need you to hang about a few dozen new paintings that just came in and be a pal and set that up, would you please? Thanks, Bob. Fernando, you twit. Don't lift a finger for those paintings. Instead, use this pen, draft a letter for me. Dear Bob, you are a nitwit and an idiot. Cordially, Ted. Cordially, Ted. That's hilarious. Oh my god, the vitriol that these guys have for one another is hilarious, and that they work opposite shifts, so they have to leave everything to each other. Oh. This is stupid. Fernando's dead, right? He didn't turn into that white corn, did he? These guys have to leave everything to each other in post-it note form because they work opposite shifts. Okay, so now I need to go back to the room where I can set up the ball. And then I'm going to use the marker and make a face on it. Use the marker to draw the worst face in the world. It appears you took drawing lessons from a leather couch. Okay, Vladdy, I got this, buddy. Let's go. And we're going to put the ball on the top. How's that look? Yeah, that looks great. What do you think, Vladdy? It's stupid. It never worked. This is all garbage. Scanning. Okay. All right, so this is Bob's room. No, Ted's room. Living quarters for Ted. Oh, it's so tidy. Whoa,
that does
what's
not
going
sound
on?
Aha! I finally found you. You've fallen into my clutches, just like all the others. I must say, I'm quite disappointed. I thought you were more clever, more interesting. But no matter. Now, your suffering will be so incomprehensible that your small mind will
stupid
break!
Stupid plant, why is your face like that?
What is that?
Your stupid face is very bad, dumb plant. Is that on purpose?
Shut up, you mean furry stupid! How dare you! I am the pinnacle of my race! You will pay for this insult. Let me just...
What's up, boy? Or get some new chicken.
Chief! If biting is cheating, I win by default. Your plans have been foiled by my plan, which are better than yours, you dummy! And I am most certainly not retreating.
You know, this place is filled with idiots.
That's awesome. So, that happened. Where did he go? Oh, he fled. Okay. The way we came in. Alright, what am I supposed to do in here? Hey, Ted. I'm sorry you had to put up with Bob. Is there anything in here? Is there nothing in here? He likes rock-hard sculpted abs and Japanese kimono women. What are we doing here? Oh, here's something. A unicorn candle holder. And a jar of Ranka. Oh, we probably go back to the trolley cart because they said Fernando was supposed to fill it with Ranka, which is like Sanka, which is like a 1970s decaf coffee thing. All right, so what is all this? Ted's journal. So many folio items. Okay. No. All right. This candle holder carving of Dave, the legendary unicorn, brought to life by a hungover demigod. This magical creature possessed near infinite foresight and a complete lack of spatial awareness. It fell to its death immediately after it was created. All right, Ted's journal, written entirely in blue pen, it in perfectly sized paragraphs, is the most depressing diary known to man. Highlights include many thoughts on optimal sock organization, regrets on his partnership with Bob, and sadness that his own project, an experimental AI program, couldn't get funded. Concerned report. A lab report outlining further tests on the facility's breakthrough test subject, the famed female Ruby Queen Corn. Much more concerning than the last one, as it uses phrases like can't be controlled, the corn follow her, and much too British. Recommends sequestering subject as soon as possible until further notice. So that's why they have her separated from the others. Local teens win MIG Science Award. It's an old newspaper clipping that shows a very young Bob and Ted winning a science award for artificial intelligence prototype. Judging by their demeanor, their partnership hasn't changed much since then. The article notably praises the display's slick presentation spearheaded by Bob and completely ignores the sciencey parts, which Ted did on his own. Okay, sorry guys, I gotta go to the bathroom. I can't hold it anymore. Be right back. Sorry about that. Too much water. Okay, so that's all our folio items. And now we're gonna go back to the trolley cart, which was downstairs in Fernando's domain. And we're going to refill it with the coffee. Right? A coffee trolley out of coffee. Fed Renka to the trolley, the coffee trolley. Do I go in here now? Can I follow it? Yes. Ooh. A script for a Broadway musical. An autobiographical play about the story of an albino corn stalk's quest to destroy something called flesh bags. The story has several continuity problems, and the choreography makes absolutely no sense unless the dancers gain the ability to transform into a quantum state and teleport from one motion to the other. The world is a bunch of stupids. One corn's journey to destroy all the flesh bags. That's hilarious. Okay, I need this stepladder. And apparently I need a bag filled with garbage. Hey, Vladdy, you said everything here is garbage, and now I actually picked up some garbage. Look it. Maybe it was the smell, maybe it was the way the light caught the plastic, but something about this particular garbage-filled bag caught your eye and never let go. You will carry it with you always. Stepladder. You vaguely remember a ladder you spotted earlier in West Hook 2 that you could access with the help of this stepladder. You note that your observation happened either a few moments ago or several centuries ago because you have little to no concept of linear time. Okay, so is that... Oh, okay. Yeah, I said you can exit the kitchen from the inside. So that's it. We just came in here to get this. What is this?
Collecting all of this garbage will not make you less stupid, idiot.
What is this? This is a thing? Framed popcorn ad. Bob was so enamored with this popcorn brand and its mascot that he framed a number of his favorite advertisements and placed them all over the facility. They were removed immediately by the staff. Professor Poppycorn! Bob, I don't care how much you love this third-rate popcorn. Stop framing ads and hanging them in here. It's stupid. Cordially, Ted. Maybe Ted turned into the albino corn, because he says everything's stupid, too. What is this? Hiya, Ted. Just to let you know, I spilled soda on some of your things and put them in here to dry out. Nothing serious, just some old moldy photos and papers in your important pile. Sorry. Bob, I hate you so much. Cordially, Ted. Right. Some glue. If you ask nicely, Vladdy can fix the door back to level 1. He won't like it, but he'll do it. He can what? Fix the door. You figure that this glue may come in useful at some point once you finally manage to unstick your head from your shoulder. Okay. So I get Vladdy to open the door for us? No. Oh. The door on level 1. What? This one? Oh, I see. Vladdy, I got a job for you. I didn't realize that this had sealed us in here.
Why does Vladdy have to fixing everything?
Please.
When is an idiot's turn?
I fix some stuff too. I'm gonna glue a gear together,
Vladdy
probably.
Not even sure what to fix. Is Vladdy supposed to hit stupid American garbage built by idiots?
Thank you, Vladdy. So now where do I go? I don't have the other part of the gear. Should I have that by now? I am not sure. To level 2. Oh. So I only have half a gear, but I do know that there's a place where I can use the step ladder down here, right? So I guess I should do that. Excuse me? I can't remember which way it was. I want to say it was this way. Get the other part out of here? Can I just take this part? No. Because that one's up already. Okay, sorry, Vladdy. I think it was the other way. Sorry, buddy. I know you don't like these long treks. This is the longest episode by far. Well, I'm going to have to stop it pretty soon, I think. Step ladder goes over here. Oh no, is this not okay? I thought it wasn't the right step ladder. Place step ladder on the floor. Now you can reach the ladder. Okay. Oh, I'm outside again? Climb ladder. Vladdy follows you somehow. Wow, and I can't go back. We're outside now, Vladdy. Okay, so I'm definitely... Gosh, I feel like I was supposed to do that gear before this. I hope that I am wrong about that. What's this? Runoff control. Okay. New building. What the heck?
The men living here look very bored.
Security quarters. Wow. All right. Okay, I think I'm going to leave it here. Because we're getting into a whole new thing now. Whole new area. So this is probably a good time to stop, right?
Bloody glad he cannot smell. It would be worse than garbage here.
Yeah. The hazardous waste is going right into the pool. Really, Bob? Okay, we're gonna leave it here. Vladdy. You're awesome, Vladdy Ruxpin. Okay, we're leaving it here. Vladdy's so cute. Alright, thanks for checking it out, guys. Since we're out of the bunker and in the outdoors, it just makes sense to stop it here and save the outdoors for part 4. Alright, thanks for checking it out. I hope you liked it. If you did like it, please press like and subscribe so you can get notifications when part 4 is up. Thanks for checking it out. Have a great day, and bye-bye.